Hello friends, this video on simple equations part 11 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now let us again look at some of the questions based on the applications of simple equations. Question number 1. Maya, Madhura and Mohsina are friends studying in the same class. In a class test in geography, Maya got 16 out of 25, Madhura got 20. Their average score was 19. How much did Mohsina score? So in this question, whose score is something that we do not know? We know that Maya scored 16. We also know Madhura scored 20. What about Mohsina? We do not know Mohsina's score. So let us assume that Mohsina's score is X. Right? Now what is the condition that is given in the question? The condition is that the average of their score is given as 19. Now considering Mohsina's score is X, Maya's score is 16 and Madhura's score is 20, how do we find the average of their scores? We have learned how to find average in the previous lesson only, right? So average is about summing them up divided by their number. So what would be the sum? X plus 16 plus 20 divided by how many of them are present? 3, Maya, Madhura and Mohsina. So this divided by 3. But according to the question, this average is actually 19. So that means X plus 16 plus 20 divided by 3 is equal to 19. So this is our equation. So how do we solve this? 6 plus 20 plus 16 is 36 divided by 3 is equal to 19. Now let's move 3 to the right hand side. So we get X plus 36 is equal to 19 into 3. So 19 into 3 is 57. So X plus 36 is equal to 57. Or we can say X is equal to 57 minus 36, which is equal to 21. Therefore, Mohsina's score is 21 out of 25. Question number 2. People of Sundargram planted a total of 102 trees in the village garden. Some of the trees were fruit trees. The number of non-fruit trees were 2 more than 3 times the number of fruit trees. What was the number of fruit trees? Now we need to find the number of fruit trees. So let us assume that the number of fruit trees is X. That is anyways our first step, is to assume something that we do not know as X. Now let's make use of the condition that is given. The condition is number of non-fruit trees is 2 more than 3 times the number of fruit trees. So 3 times the number of fruit trees plus 2 more, that is 3x plus 2. This is going to be the number of non-fruit trees. Now according to the question, the total number of trees that was planted was 102. So total number of trees would be fruit plus non-fruit trees. The sum of these two is equal to 102. Now fruit trees is X, non-fruit trees is 3X plus 2. So basically X plus 3X plus 2 is equal to 102. So X plus 3X would be 4X plus 2 is equal to 102. So let's solve this to find out the value of X. So 4X will be equal to 102 minus 2. Or we can say 4X is equal to 100. Therefore, X is equal to 100 divided by 4. So we know that 4 into 25 is 100. Therefore, X is equal to 25. And what was X? X was the number of fruit trees. So the number of fruit trees planted is 25. Question number 3. Ibenhal thinks of a number. If she adds 19 to it and divides the sum by 5, she will get 8. So you have to definitely find that number. So let us say that let the number be X. Now she adds 19 to that number, that means X plus 19, and then she divides this sum by 5, that means X plus 19 divided by 5. And what does she get? She gets the result as 8. So this is a pretty simple equation and we can definitely solve this. So this becomes X plus 19, we move 5 to right hand side, so it becomes 8 into 5. So X plus 19 is equal to 8 into 5, that is 40. So we can say X is equal to 40 minus 19. Therefore, X is equal to 21. So 21 is the number that she thought of. Question number 4. If I take 3/4 of a number and count up 3 more, I get 21. What is the number? So again, pretty simple. Let us say that the number is x. So what are we actually doing? We take 3/4 of this number, that means 3/4x, and then we count up 3 more. That means we are adding 3 more to it. So 3/4x plus 3, and what do we get? We get 21. So 3/4x plus 3 is equal to 21. This is our equation and we have to find x. So let us first move this 3 to right hand side. So we get 21 minus 3. So we can say 3/4x is equal to 18. Or this 4 can move this side. So this becomes 3x is equal to 18 into 4. Or we can say 3x is equal to 18 into 4 is 72. Or x is equal to 72 divided by 3. So 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12. So x is equal to 24. So the number is 24. So with this, we have reached towards the end of this lesson, and I'm very sure that you would have felt that this lesson on simple equations was very, very interesting and simple as well. As the name said, simple equations, the equations were pretty simple to solve and to make them. So trying to solve more and more questions, this is a very interesting lesson. If you try solving it yourself, it's really good. You are really going to be very, very good at it. So read the question, understand it, set up an equation following the tips that I gave you, and then solve the equations very simply using the 4 tips that I had mentioned. So I hope this lesson would have helped you. See you all in the next lesson. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.